Welcome to part 2 of 3 of the Building Blocks video tutorial. This video will go through the minute steps of creating a report to include the MicroStrategy design and report modes and history list options. Today's use case will look at a brand and generic drug utilization amongst beneficiaries for the Medicare Advantage Prescription Drug Program. Metrics will include gross drug cost amount and PDE fills. We will intersperse BI tool technical training as we go. Okay, we spoke about where to begin this whole shebang, the shared reports region. We'll start from scratch, choosing blank report. The design mode is made up of concrete areas for report creation. The left pane is the objects pane and contains the available data elements for queries. The right side, commonly referred to as the work area, is where you'll add columns and apply filters. Behind the scenes, this will be the select statement and where clauses, respectively. There's no need to deal with all the complex joins. This has all been accounted for in the development of the Building Blocks project. Where you're likely to begin is in the Attributes folder. Clicking on that link brings you to the top-level Attributes folders. You may navigate to the location where the column resides by folder hierarchy, or if you know the column name, you can click inside the search field and begin typing. Okay, here's a report we'll create to summarize drugs used across therapeutic categories based on brand and generic, or both, and drug products as either single or multiple source original drug products or generic copy of standard drug product. Our aha moment comes from the quantifiable components of the report, the metrics. Let's unpack these a bit. Here's an example of a customized data element developed for exclusive use in the Building Blocks project. The gross drug cost amount is compiled from 4 amounts and excludes servicing fees. This is calculated on your behalf. PDE fills comes in the form of claim unique IDs. Calculations and counts can also be added on the fly. Those custom filters really save time. You can construct the filters and prompts in longhand if you wish, but are out of scope for this video tutorial. We're big fans of automated mechanisms built inside the tool itself to expedite querying. The date range for this example is Beni effective and Beni obsolete dates for January of 2021. All the joining is done behind the scenes, saving more time. All right, here we go. Now that we know what we're looking for, let's get right to it. We need a primary, secondary, and tertiary therapeutic categories. Let's start building the select statement in MicroStrategy BI by initially navigating to the Building Blocks Attributes folder. Click inside the search field, type therapeutic. Hit the Enter key on your keyboard. The search criteria brings up 5 Building Blocks columns. You can do one of 2 methods to populate the columns into the work area. In the All Objects pane, double-clicking on each data element separately. They will be added to the work area from left to right in order of double-clicking. Or you may control-click on each separately and drag and drop to the work area. Ensure you are adding attributes to the column level. A telltale sign is the vertical yellow bar denoting column level insertion. They'll be inserted in the same manner. Next, we want the drug product name. Keying in product name will find it. If you keyed in drug product name, you wouldn't get a hit on that column in Building Blocks. When searching, use more generic criteria to widen results. The search term product name reveals claim line national drug code product name. Double-click on the data element to insert to the work area. Upon insertion, I want to rename this, and conventional thinking would suggest to right-click on it. Here's a little interface quirk. From the Report Objects pane, right-click on the column in question and choose Rename from the drop-down menu. Rename to a more suitable column name. Click OK. And navigate back to the All Objects pane. Next up, and searching from the same Attributes folder, Brand and Generic Identifier. This will come in the form of an identifier that encompasses multiple sources, brand and generic. keying in the word multiple in the search field will bring up data attributes to add to the select statement. There are a few here, and I'm not sure which one it is. Hovering over the data elements in the All Objects pane reveals a tooltip. This text is directly from the Building Blocks data catalog, seen earlier from the Building Blocks landing page. This has been added to the work area and renamed accordingly, something easy on the eyes. Doubling back to the All Objects pane from the Report Objects pane displays the last column search. Click on the All Objects pane drop-down menu and select Metrics. We know what we want here, and all the metrics can be searched from the top level. Key in gross drug cost amount. Hit the Enter key on your keyboard. Similar to inserting attributes, double-click on the metric. It adds to the work area. It is inserted automatically as a row-based element versus a column-based element as we saw with the attributes. The way we know this is how the other method of data element insertion works. When dragging and dropping a metric from the All Objects pane to the work area, ensure you are placing onto the horizontal line, again represented with a yellow line, similar to how we saw the insertion earlier. We'll stick with metrics as row-based, as we saw in the double-click method. Next, we want to explore the number of beneficiaries who got a PDE claim. This one's not as intuitive. Drug utilizing Benny is derived from PDE Benny's number. Hit Enter to bring up that column in the All Objects pane. For you data geeks out there, this one's in Claim Line Auxiliary, and it's the count of beneficiaries that have a PDE claim. Double-clicking on it adds it to the work area to the right of the previously inserted metric. Once inserted in the work area, to rename that column to a more aesthetically pleasing name from the Report Objects pane, click Rename from PDE Benny's number. We'll rename it to Drug Utilizing Benny. That's more like it, and tells the story of what data will be displayed in report mode. Click OK. Doubling back to the All Objects pane, the prior search is remembered. PDE fills is the count of number of claims. All right, let the plot thicken here. Next, I'd like to see the gross drug cost amount per beneficiaries. There isn't an IDR column that accounts for this in particular, so we'll create a calculation from existing IDR metrics. The count of bennies will be the denominator. We've searched for it in the metrics folder and added it to the work area. Even though we won't be using this metric in the report as a standalone column, we still need it in the overall pool of data elements, or report objects, so as to create a new metric. Merely remove it from the report by clicking the X in the column header. It will not be removed from the overall objects in the report itself. So with that knowledge in hand, go to the Report Objects pane to create the new metric. Right-click on Benny Count and choose Insert New Metric from the drop-down menu. We'll name the new metric exactly what we're looking for, Gross Drug Cost Amount per Benny. To kick off the process of creating the metric, the numerator is first. Double-click on Gross Drug Cost Amount from the report objects. Either key in a forward slash to denote a divisor operator, or click the divided by sign above the typing field. Double-click on Benny Count. The equation is complete. If this calculation was more complex, we might want to validate the syntax of the equation. No need here in this example. A new derived metric is now available for reporting purposes. If you'd like to shift the location of the columns, drag and drop to the desired location in the work area. Okay, everything looks good so far. Gosh, that was a lot of work. Wait, I don't believe I've saved this work. It's still named blank report. Click on the Save button on the toolbar. The Save dialog displays the My Reports folder by default. This is your personal folder to store items. We've named this report National Drug Summary for Brand and Generic. Click OK. The report is saved, and you are prompted to take action as to whether you'd like to run the newly saved report or return to design mode. Well, we've not created any filters, so returning to design mode is appropriate in this scenario. filters can be added to the report from the All Objects pane. Filters can be added manually by searching for the raw data elements and adding to the report filters area. Instead, we'll use the predefined filters to really save time. The Public Objects folder contains shared filters. This is where the 272 predefined filters reside. First up, Claim From Date. This canned filter is a bookend prompt. Drag and drop to the report filters area. It is added. To create this manually is a bit cumbersome using the Claim From Date attribute. Next up, Final Action Claims. Drag and drop the Claim Final Action indicator equals Y to the report filter area. An AND operator defaults between Claim From Date's prompt and Claim Final Action indicator filter. Next, we want to ensure there is a claim in the date range we'll assign when addressing the Claim From Date prompt. Part D Claims will filter on only claim type codes 1, 2, and 4. We are not interested in deleted claims. This graphic is from the Claim Type Code section of the Data Dictionary user interface. There's one more filter to go, and this time we'll assemble from the Attributes area. We're interested in exposing Medicare Advantage prescription drug information, so we've searched on that. Part D, PDP, MAPD, may do the trick. Hovering over that column displays the tooltip. Yep, this will do. In fact, it looks like there might be a scenario where I can pick and choose what I want out from this filter. Same drill. Drag and drop to the report filters area. This time, we're going to need to do a little work. Click the Select Radio button. There are a couple of options, as insinuated from the name of the predefined filter. Double-click on the MAPD option. It's now selected. Click Apply. Assembling from scratch would entail using the core attributes to assemble this filter. And just for a point of order, if both MAPD and PDP were chosen, which is permitted, we'd get all the information included based on the Part D contract types. For now, we'll stick with the Medicare Advantage prescription drug for this query. I'm a big fan of save and save often, especially before running reports. Now that we got that one out of the way, click Run Report. A date prompt appears, and the start and end dates are December 1st and December 31st, 2020, respectively, to denote December of 2020. The report message name field can be adjusted to conform to the date prompt in the previously created MAPD filter. The report will process. There are four options. Check status again, add to my history list, show report details, and cancel. Cancel will cancel the processing request, and you'll be brought back to the design mode screen. Show report details displays the report name and description, and more importantly, the Teradata SQL that was assembled as a consequence of all that dragging and dropping, etc. Closing out of the report details brings you back to the processing request screen. The Add to My History list adds the report to a cached area of executed reports. Upon clicking Add to My History list, Go to My History list now appears. Clicking on that displays the history list. The current report is currently running, and data retrieval will depend on the complexity of the query. A single user can have up to 3 concurrent queries. After that, queries 4 and above will be put in queue. Once complete, a status of ready is displayed. Click on that to view the report in report mode. Report mode displays the report based upon the criteria we gave it in design mode. In fact, to navigate back to design mode, there's a pencil button on the data toolbar. Uh-oh, I just realized I forgot an attribute, one to denote whether the drug was brand or generic. Let's add it from the attributes folder. Keying in brand in the search field brings up a few options. Claim line NDC brand generic identifier is just the column I need to round this out, and it's been renamed accordingly and moved from right to left. While I'm at it, I move the gross drug cost amount per penny next to gross drug cost amount. Rerun the report. Once ready in the history list, click on it to view in report mode. All right, looks great. The report details area displays the filter conditions run on the query. The prompt details section shows the start and end dates selected from the claim from dates prompt. There are a lot of BI tool options to really make this report sing. The page by this field option on each column header allows the report to be filtered on the fly. The brand generic column is now set up to tweak the output in report mode. And if you're looking closely, that column isn't in the report columns as it's the pivot point for customized output. Dropping the menu of options down and choosing, say, G for generic will modify the records displayed. Page by this field can be set up for multiple columns. There's an unknown value represented by a tilde here, so only that single row is showing in this example. Choosing N to denote a single source, now the report is adjusted to display generic single source data. The report is currently sorted by therapeutic class number 1. Clicking on the downward facing arrow, which is sort descending, to make sort ascending. Now this is starting to look like a report I'm interested in. I need a little bit more real estate so I can remove the prompt details pane for more report mode space. I just noticed the derived metric I created should be currency based. Right-click in the column header and choose Advanced Formatting from the menu. Choose the Number tab from the Format dialog, select the Currency Radio button, and keep all the other defaults. Looks good. I want to now sort ascending on the calculation column, Gross Drug Cost Amount per Benny, but the Ascending button is hidden as the column isn't wide enough. Now that the sort triangle is available, choose Sort Ascending. Bringing the Page by This Field option back to the grid is completed by dragging and dropping to the report in the location of your choosing. The Drug Multi Single Source is reinserted in the report. Add the Brand Generic Page by This Field back to the report. To reprompt the report so as to get a different date range, say, select Reprompt from the Data menu. A new bookended date range is for November of 2020, and the report message name field is adjusted to accommodate the new criteria. The history list displays the report running. Earlier we saw how to view the report details information. We can also view from the Details button for the corresponding report in the history list. You may also export options in the history list. Export options include output type and header and footer options. Looks like the records are retrieved. Let's give a look. Mission accomplished. Grid reports are one thing, but how do I display this data graphically? A Create Dossier button on the toolbar will launch a Visual Insight module for dashboard or dossier creation. The report is ready. We're ready to roll. Now let's get into the dossier. Scope out video 3 for a little primer as to what one would see in the MicroStrategy dossier interface.